Can I sit this way?
No,
sure.
And then if one of you would be so kind as to don't touch the red button, just
make
like,
sure. It looks
move
like
this
everybody's
around.
Gonna be in it.
We good? So.
How about now?
We'll try to keep the chatter.
This will make it easier to turn that.
No, we won't! No, we won't. I'm gonna be heckling.
I'm just making him feel
Chris's
better.
Head, right?
You can also go like, and go like that.
Put it in a different place. I'm here.
You
can
probably sell the lights.
Hey, I'm watching the show over.
Oh, yeah, all right. Then do whatever, as long as it's in there and.
You can have Chris's head dome on there.
We can Photoshop him out. Just don't press the red button that stops it.
Hey, if it's a show, my head is going to be in the way somewhere.
Oh, yeah, there's that.
See, why does he know this? I mean, I'm like,
I've used these.
I know. What I'm saying is, you're brighter than everybody here at the table.
Yeah,
I was going to get a talk.
I should think that.
Could we get two coffees, please?
Yeah, just give me a second. I'm cleaning up.
No problem. No problem. Thank you.
I keep things out. That's what I
mean. What do what?
I keep things out. That's what I mean. Yeah.
I asked myself.
Yeah, so I've been listening to pretty much Bouncing Souls since getting home. And I'm really glad that I have, because like I'm finally going, now I'm going to spend the time.
His first couple of records, like, he couldn't sing very well at all. But then he kind of followed up and got really good.
Oh, man. I'm loving. Yeah. It's been great. You know what it is?
What?
Doc Martens. With the Bouncing Souls.
Because it started out as like a skin.
Yeah. Oh no, it
yeah, it's S O L.
Yeah, no, I get it. Yeah.
Yeah. No, I know. When
I
they
still don't like it.
I'm not fond of the name, never have been. I remember reading their first review in Maximum Rock and Roll, and they it was for their demo, and they compared it to the Big Boys, and I was like, yes, go on. And it was not, and I went, I'm not so sure, but that I heard the demo and I just went, okay, forget.
There's just two names I actually like.
Oh, I do. You know, certainly not fluid.
Yeah.
Then again,
water music?
Not a fan of that band. But the Bouncing Souls?
Yeah.
I've, oh my God.
I said about 8 to 10 years ago, I got really into it. And just kind of fell off for whatever reason. Well, it's because I feel like I don't listen to music as much as I used to. It was also the time when on weekends I would listen to shopping. And I don't do that anymore. So.
It has to be pretty cheap to buy a CD.
Oh, hey, so.
Yeah. Here, I'll give you the rundown.
They're not filming anything.
No.
He is actually filming right now.
Oh, God.
No, I'm just scooting over here.
But anyway, so. Michael Nolan. Michael Nolan. I'm in a boy called Freeman. On September 12th, right here, in front of the Waverly. But unfortunately, I lost his address. He was last in his room. Don't know, he resembles George Harrison. The Beatles, but he wears his hair. Charlie was small, but at the back. I love him, but it embarrasses me. Walk down the street with him. He lives in Brooklyn somewhere. Anywhere, says white crash helmet. He has golden chains on his leather jacket. And on the back are written names, Mary and Mom and Hell's Angels. I'll be grateful and appreciate it if you see him, tell him I'm in the bar with my girlfriend, Angelique. Tell her Angela and I don't want the $2 back. Just
yeah. I should have a
guitar bonus. Yeah. Okay.
Oh, here comes Scott.
We got it ironed out.
Good. Okay, perfect. Thank you.
Do you want cream and sugar?
Yes, please.
Okay. You okay over here?
Can I get the quesadilla? Or I guess her whole thing wasn't worried.
Add white?
She's like, I just feel like
turkey. You want to add white? I'm like,
you do, absolutely. But you've also been given reason to.
Yeah.
Okay.
So we kind of smooth it out for now.
Well, I'm glad. Yeah. I'm glad. Well, because like.
Her birthday, so we're going to go to brunch with her.
Okay, good. Well, both of you need to be a little more straightforward. So, not so bad then?
Yeah, not so bad.
Okay, good.
Yeah,
I'm glad.
She didn't say she was worried. She was like,
yeah, because I was going to say, nice try.
Yeah, no, she didn't say that. She was just like, I feel like you don't care. And I was like, she's got me there.
How can I put this?
Because I have free.
How can I put this where I don't let you know what I'm really thinking? How can I say what I'm feeling without being honest?
I've been watching 90 Day Fiancé because it's very funny. And they have this one lady who came in. So, like, his friends are all worried because she, and he said, they're like, well, do you really love him? And she said, I never said I love him. And you know, and it was just like,
because, like, I feel like it's going to fall off.
I just want to make sure all
three. Oh, yeah, of course. I can't see.
I need this, like, an irritant. Like, trying to really, like,
this is like, I said, let's wait
for this. I loved when we were in
the I can't want
to. Went up to him and saw his eyes bug out. And then he runs with him. So it's so. Don't stop filming this for 1 second. I'm going. Like, I'm going to turn it around and turn it off. That requires work. But he was just so worried. I was like, screw it up. And I was like, really? What do you think I'm going to do?
Did you
get
your friend
to cover this? We never had time.
We had all these stupid ideas.
He said to tell her.
I said,
Moe, is the video going? Is the video going?
It's gone.
Thanks, sir.
Yeah.
I got to answer
for
Lori. About
that time.
Hi, everybody.
Can we get some sexier lighting? Or is this sexy
enough? Like,
oh, thank you. Thank you.
Oh, I'm getting
serious now.
Good evening.
I guess I am a host. Thanks everybody for coming and hanging out. This is Mr. Kevin Seconds. And for some reason they let me sit up here and play songs with them on occasion. My name's Nolan. Thank you everyone for coming and hanging out.
Tonight is Nolan's birthday week.
That too. And tonight is the second to last show at Luna's. Oh. Sad and you what?
Third to last.
Maybe I'm wrong.
No, I thought that too. I've been saying.
Okay. I would love for there to be more music at Luna's. I hope I'm wrong on that. As far as I know, it's tonight and it's tomorrow, and that's it.
But until we're told otherwise by our lawyers, we can be.
Right.
Yeah, I'm gonna go around wearing stage paint and calling myself the penultimate warrior.
What I'm interested in is there is still a no covers sign up there.
Yeah.
I feel like the bill for that would be going to the new owners at this point. Whom I don't know and who want to turn this place into a piano bar. So I'm like, all right, well, how much do I care about a piano? I'm kidding.
Okay, so pianists hold out.
You want to start? That's like that. We'll go like this way.
Dinner? Oh, sure.
Yes.
Yeah. Is guitar too low? Yeah. Does it seem pretty even? Yeah. Okay.
We're here to rock, Kevin.
I know.
If it's too loud, we're too old. Something.
Definitely or something.
More guitar bell.
Kevin would be on the extreme ninja end of the spectrum, and I would be on the other end of that spectrum.
No, come on.
I think we've actually arranged seating in order
to that's fair.
I always offer them songs, but they never take any of them. I'll just give you songs. I'll give you bags of songs.
I would love to have Like, done and done.
We'll tell them.
Right.
To grab it, and then I realized, oh, that pickup that I paid for getting fixed apparently was just some money I gave to someone. So as long as I don't move my guitar, it won't go, couldn't sound like, yeah, someone electrocuting a cornflake. I don't know how often that happens in nature. But I mean, their workplace is wet. It's probably a real risk. All right. There's enough of that.
Don't pretend you never planned to end it this way. Close your eyes as if it disguises us from all that you see. And we've been fighting. Thank you.
Facebook.
I was mortified too.
Yeah, but specifically, besides my usual baseline state of mortification, I saw the picture of you guys singing a thing, and I thought, no, did I miss thing? Because I was like, yeah, I was afraid that
why
I
were
missed.
You in New York with us? What the hell?
Yeah.
Why you make fun of us?
We were there.
Well, I was, but I was at Old York. No one. Yeah, I was in England like an idiot. It's like a new right. New York. Well, sure. Yeah. Well, I paid for the ticket.
Next time. all right, cool.
Kevin, I have a question for you real quick.
Yes.
You said the whole song was new-ish. What does new-ish mean to you? Like, within the last week, year?
Improvised mid-song?
Since the beginning of the year.
Okay.
Beginning of the year?
Yeah.
Okay.
I played it.
I needed a point of reference.
Okay. I'll let you know when
so
I...
So for me, when I say new, I'm like, within the last 5 years.
Okay. That's a good question, because I, you know, I don't know that. Well, this is an older song from the mid-90s.
Ooh. Oh, dude. Okay.
First, because that would be much better.
It's not great. Yeah, 90s if you tune. Tune is a little more 90s authentic.
Yeah, it's super 2004 of you if you tune.
Right.
I got to see that. There's too many things to think about when you're trying to make music.
Such as.
Let's
well,
about.
Like what year your tuning falls into. Like, is this a, you know, maybe 1 year it's like, hey, nobody's tuning, man. What's
yeah.
wrong with you?
What are you doing?
Your hair looks amazing.
Thank you. I've been using a new shampoo imported from a different country. I pay a fortune for it. And yet I still can order it on Amazon. It's great.
We didn't plan it this way, but I like the symmetry of the stage of the long hair.
I was thinking
on both sides. It'll look good in the video. Very balanced.
Like little fuzzy bookends.
Yep. Our feng shui game is on point tonight.
Absolutely.
So is anybody is as excited as I am to see after Art closes down, him just hanging out in his yacht, just chilling? Can't wait.
It's well earned.
It's well deserved. Retirement to him. The song's called God. If we never knew, we could have some fun. But God be on the roof, take
on anyone. No, I don't have to watch.
I'm gonna feel
it.
Okay.
Did you want another beer?
I wish to God that I was there.
Early.
I didn't think I was right, but I couldn't think of what the other possible answers.
Yeah, I don't know if it ever counted. I don't. You would know that better than me.
Chris would know that better than I would.
Yeah, it was on one of the things.
One of those things.
Maybe. Yeah, I don't know. I mean, you deal with that.
Well, that's the whole point. We don't know.
Yeah, no, it's on one.
It's like a big mystery. It's a song. It was written. It was recorded. That's all.
That's fair.
Class.
That's important. That's fair. We all agree it is a song. And since you played a song from 20 years ago, I'll play one from 20 years ago too.
Oh, alright.
Which is the last time I released a solo album. Yeah.
Everybody good? Cozy? Setting in?
Thank you.
You could do worse. Keep doing that. Okay, here we go. You could do worse. Fun lower than my... What is the word?
Settle down with it.
That's what it is. I was so distracted by the fact. I was like, oh, I see. Oh, you know these songs.
I texted you, Alex.
That's... What's that?
I texted you, Lyric.
Okay, thank you. Yeah. I was told I'd be fitted with an anklet to prevent this from happening.
Oh, yeah.
All right. You could do worse. I settled down with a nice boy. I guess you know better. Or maybe you could care less. I'm given the choice. You fall in love to the feeling. And all you were left with is anyone's guess. So tell me your best life. There's no heart in the wheel. Every sweet, sick word over your eyes. I swear the sun will never set on us.
This is a song called The Lion Died Tonight. This is a... No, this is 2018.
Just... Noted.
Pre-pandemic. Let's see if I can do this. All right.
Well, I watch for my boat as they bought in the mess they made. Faces drained of blood behind the barricade. The TV news was there and the mayor joined. but they couldn't hide the truth from all the looky-loos who stayed. Wanna send this message out to all of those who pray.
Second chances, and to my big she's all
penchant for disaster.
Yes.
Ah, I wish we didn't know each other. I'd totally steal that.
I
didn't even use it in conversations.
Full disclosure, I stole half of that lyric from somebody else.
Oh, nice.
So take half of it and do what you want.
Okay, cool. I'll be like, didn't Nolan... I stole this from someone Nolan doesn't even know.
But the guy... So I stole it from Jonah, because they've got a... There's a little far song where he says, she's got a penchant for disaster. I'm like, oh, I'm nicking that in here.
Yeah.
But he is also stolen, like, from Peter Gabriel and Prince. And on, like,
records. Man, you're just snitching on yourself. You're snitching on yourself.
I know, right? Never mind. That's all bullshit. It's my lyric.
What about the code, man? The code.
I think it's just good we presume ignorance on our audience. Here's a song I wrote called When Doves Cry.
Something is going to come to that. Now you're on to something. How about eagles, though?
Probably. And maybe instead of cry, like an eagle's caterwaul or something. Yeah. When Doves Cry.
You sell it to show
what a ridiculous song that would be. Okay, let's see. Here's a song. It was like, why do you even make the pretense of putting me back?
I like that you brought back a capo just in case the first capo is not enough.
I did. And the sad thing is, there's a song that might need two capos. It's like, I don't want to play any chords at all. Here, you guys just hang on to the... This is a song in which the chorus goes, she. All right, those are your notes. All right, you guys got it? Okay, perfect. Two people just walked in, like, what is this?
I'm in Alex's band and I have no idea what you're doing.
The words are she. What song are you? Doesn't matter.
All right.
I don't need to learn more chords. You don't need to learn
more chords.
Reasons not to doubt her. He is masterminding your escape.
Oh, doesn't like you when you leave. She's alone with other voices whispering. She's alone with other voices whispering. She's alone with every voice still screaming. She isn't what you need.
Quiet Song has multiple references to things and people in Sacramento in it. Does that change your You thought at all?
This could be.
Whereas the loud song has baseball references.
Ooh, quiet song.
Quiet song?
Bore your audience.
Right. Stockton chiming in. Surly Stockton, Stocktonians. What are you? What are Stockton? Stocktonites?
Stocktonians.
You're so surly.
Hey.
Touch me all the way down with that fist.
What do you want from me?
Oh. And surprisingly hostile toward baseball.
Is it maybe because you're
after a Utah
minor league team sucks?
Ooh,
I don't even know.
Burn.
There's
got to
be a
seconds.
Minor league team.
I come right
it's there for the convention center.
I would think so. I would think so. It's getting hot in here.
Yeah, you attacked the place's farm league team. The song at a songwriting contest a few years ago, and the good news is it won, and the bad news is when they gave me the little like award thing you won, they spelled the name of the song wrong. They got my name right, which is
was it Eric first?
No, it was actually Nolan Erck. I think it was spelled correctly. The song is called I Wish I Was an Astronaut, and the paper I have says I Wish I Was an Astrunt.
So you have to sing it that way.
Right?
Sometimes you take what you can give, and you throw yourself onto me, and I'm left to clean up the mess. And I feel like I could die tonight, and everything would be alright, cause you're always looking up when I'm falling over. Maybe something special that wasn't worth the fight. Don't repeat pictures from your broken diary. You've used up all the best lines you should have saved me. You'll tell me everything's alright.
Thank you.
me believe till the end of the world, to the top of the world. Yeah.
severed part. I'm letting you go, missing the part of God. Letting you go, still missing the part. But I'm letting you go.
This is a song from the 1980s. Oh, I see, I've got a bunch of youngsters in this room.
Do tell.
Well, it was a strange decade.
That was before cell phones.
Dude. Absorbed into them because they speak to your very core of your soul. And that song and that entire album that's on and Alex's last song, Letting You Go, are on that list for me. That so far several weeks album is a freaking masterpiece, Kevin.
Thank you, sir.
I'm certain I'm not the only person in this room that feels that way, too.
You will take this compliment, listen to it, and you will not give a rebuttal.
On the opposite end of that spectrum, I was talking to my friend, Greg ages ago. He lived here in Sacramento and moved to Seattle, and we were texting, and he said, are you playing any bands up there right now, writing any music? And he didn't say yes or no. He said, I'm writing every night in my bedroom. As in, you know, he's screwing around on guitar, but not in a band. And this is a song about that. It's called Every Night in My Bedroom. Yeah. Despite the suggested title, it is not sexy time.
Alone? I can do
something
about this.
Nor is it about alone sexy time. What's that songwriting edit? Write What You Know? Maybe it should have been about that.
Oh, lonely, sexy time in baseball.
I can't even think of another song that is, dude.
You're welcome.
Right?
Don't show up in that hat and tell me it's not sexy time.
I'm
here.
Them broke up last year. I think it was in June. My job was the singer, and I wrote most of the tunes. It got hard to find four guys who all wanted to play, with reliable transportation to practice every day. It's been too long since the shows. You're in the crowds, all sing along. But I've been writing every day, and I've got a brand new hit song with ultra catchy lyrics and a brand new set of chords. It's too bad no one hears it outside this bedroom door. I rock every night in my bedroom to 1,000 screaming fans. They're mostly action figures. I live at home with my mom and dad. When the posters cheer my name and the toys turn down the lights, I picture screaming kids, and then I rock the bedroom again tonight. The intro was the work. Transformers, you know, I don't really know. And the lampshade in the corner didn't really seem to mind that I stole a couple words from Wanted Dead or Alive. And Hendrix said he loved it, thought I was getting closer. Caught in the purple haze of my black felt. Screaming kids, and then I run. Tim Macy had a shirt at camp, and it had like a picture of who I later learned was Richie Sambora. But as a Quaker, I had never seen the profile of any rocker who wasn't, you know, in striper. It's amazing the amount of access Quaker kids growing up had to striper, which is a decidedly bad influence. But it was Richie Sambora with his guitar protruding phallically upward, and it had like a list of all the tour dates and tour places. You know, imagine a band going on tour. They list the places. I'm not sure how it works. It's very intricate. But and it said in like the 80th of rock fonts, you know, 78 cities and 48,812 fans, can't be wrong. And I just thought that was so awesome. And I would just sit there and stare at it until one time Tim turned around and was like, "Dude." And there's just no cool way for you to be like, "Yeah, I was just reading the tour destinations on your Jeremy shirt." It was fine. I faked a seizure and it was over. So this is a song that has a Bon Jovi quote. You'll hear it. There's an understated tetanus risk, though, from riding a steel horse.
Killer of dreams, thank you very much. I was just thinking.
Me and tetanus, yes.
Wow.
Look at that.
And all I can think of is that, all I can think of is that crab show. The catch, it takes a crab catcher. What is the show where they go crab fishing? What is it?
Deadliest Catch.
Because that's the thing.
Did they do it? Oh.
What the hell are you talking about?
On a seahorse.
That Bon Jovi song is the theme for the what's it called? Deadliest Catch. It's like a reality show.
Crap,
where these guys go to the Bering Strait.
It takes a crab catcher.
This is a song that's a couple months old.
Never got the message, but the muffin didn't get it. And maybe it's not quite as simple as we might get another drink, but I can't promise better prices, pretty shabby, big surprises. I love you, well, for sure.
this is the aforementioned song with multiple Sacramento type references in it. See if you can spot them all. It'll be like Where's Waldo, but with pop songs.
Bingo.
Captain Mitch.
Exactly.
Do you remember Captain Mitch?
No, I remember Captain Geach on the Shrimp Chartreuse, though.
Oh! Captain Geach.
I think we're talking about another party.
What's Captain Mitch?
Captain Mitch was he was like a kid show, morning show host. Kid show cartoon. He was like a little Captain Mitch. And it was sort of like, you remember Romper Room?
Oh yeah.
It was like, they'd have kids in the studio with the poor bastards that hosted the show, and I'm sure the clean speakers and... Hey, I didn't make it up, alright? It happened.
I just don't know Captain Mitch. I grew up...
It was in the 60s.
When I'm, okay. That works. 70s.
Listen quietly. There's a bar downtown past S on 10th Street where on Wednesday nights we would go to meet. You would watch me play so contently. To keep the dog at the couch that I'm just for a while. I've got work in the morning, driving home tonight. And this talk of engagement rings has got me thinking. This talk of engagement rings has got me thinking. We have little discussions about much bigger things. Long royale, not for dry screens. Long soft kisses in the parking lot. And other things I'm betting that you forgot. Says they'll never forget. It's full of birthday cards and photographs. Though my phone bill was heavy, it was worth every penny. After more than 2 years, this mess seems kind of funny, but stranger things have happened even to me. Don't know where I went wrong or how we ever let it go from bad to worse to done right. But then you do what you think's best, and I will too. You do what you think's best, and I will too. Discussions about much bigger things, like Mocha Royale, not for dry screen. Long soft kisses in the parking lot. Other things I'm betting that you forgot. Letter that's waiting for your reply. that's the waiting. None of that's the waiting.
Thanks. Me that like it's a show about a ship and like there's not a bit of land. The whole it's a steel horse.
Steel fish, I ride.
Yeah, I'm still working it out. I'm still a little grumpy about the whole endeavor. So I chased a girl to London. They'll go that far if you keep chasing them. And there was a night that I got engaged in the watching of people in Trafalgar Square. And if you've ever watched Mary Poppins, you've seen Trafalgar Square, and you've seen the whimsical old lady as the saints and apostles look down as she spreads her, as she sells her wares. And although you can't see them, they know that they're smiling. Time so much else that they care. So the Feed the Birds lady, I thought it was really cool. There was someone there selling bird seed. So you too, in Trafalgar Square, very similar to Mary Poppins, could have that pastoral scene where you're feeding the birds. And this was super fun to watch, but not for the reasons that I expected. I was like, oh, this will be so serene and tranquil and romantic. And instead, a happy tourist would go and pay and get their bird seed and immediately just be set upon by these deeply cynical and not about waiting pigeons who would just not even go for the thing. They were just like, if I land on his head and peck, he'll drop the thing. And I know this because it's happened 4 billion times before. And so these nearly flightless out of just sheer obesity pigeons would just set upon this person and they would crumple like one of those, you know, after school specials in which they would show in like the fast motion what like either lack of sunlight or drugs would do to something, and they would just like, ah, just fling it, and then the pigeons would waddle over and go it, you know, and then the other person would, you know, go off to staunch their wounds, and has anyone seen my cornea? And they would, and then the little seed lady would go, and she had like a little, what came later to be known as a Swiffer, but she had a little sort of thing and would just go and then just like reset the scene as if nothing catastrophic had happened, and she'd wait for the next group of tourists to depart the tube, and she'd be like, oh, would you like to feed the bird? And then, ah! And then carnage would happen. So I got busy watching that and forgot, oh, hostels have like a 9 o'clock curfew, and so I was finally alone in Trafalgar Square, and there was an F sharp being played on the bell from St. Catherine in the Fields, and so I wrote this romantic a song about a girl who would eventually successfully elude me. Midnight is falling on Trafalgar Square, with 4 days between you and me, and nothing's forever. And nothing is fair. It's nothing I care to
It's back on the square, and I struggle to breathe. The sky is as high and as dark with desire as my patience is faltering.
Truth be told, it was
Is that the last musical thing? Is there something going on next week?
No, so I have, just for my post-birthday thing, I hired some strippers to come
in. Male and female.
The man knows how to go out.
Actually, boom. No, I'm just kidding. Yeah, we've got actually next week a pretty much a full lineup of events.
Okay.
Except for Monday, our jazz thing. The guy that booked that show forgot. This is Monday, so
okay.
I think we'll be closed Monday night, and we'll be back and use a break. Yeah. We're going to do a great, a wonderful jazz show Tuesday evening, and then we've got open mic comedy
okay.
Wednesday and Thursday.
I'm so screwed up. I thought tomorrow night is the last thing. Okay, I think I told a few people that, so that's good to know. Okay, that's
fine. And then we've got the Punch Show on Friday night, which has been a great comedy series that you're doing with these guys. Just amazing. I never knew there were so many puns out there. And then Proxy Moon and you will be here next Saturday.
Yeah. Okay.
And then Sunday, I think, will be just a kind of a open house.
You're not really closing, are you? This is really
gonna get people coming. It's like one of those clearance sales that you see in the Midwest.
I just wanted to get it out August 1st, but I said, no, I've got some shows planned for
the okay.
So we're going to do that. And actually, originally, it wasn't supposed to end until the end of August, and they bumped it up on me, and I said, oh, wait a minute.
Okay, yeah.
Yeah, so. So that next Sunday will be a kind of an open house. It's kind of a thank you for people who want to come in. Yeah.
Yeah.
The strippers will be back?
That's going to be post.
Oh,
Sunday.
Okay.
Spontaneous.
Monday, August 7th will be the last show, and that's going to be what's called the hat gig, where all the jazz guys put their names into a hat, and they pick a trio, and then they just go up and
improvise. Oh, wow. Great.
Wow.
I'll be, the 8th will actually be my last day here. That'll be probably a day to just kind of pack some stuff up.
Yeah.
I don't have much to take because the new old guy is going to, he bought me out. It's right. Turnkey, so I'm going to take the art and papers and that kind of stuff. And then he's going to deal with the rest.
And it's a piano? What's it going to be?
Well, it's ostensibly it's a piano bar.
Okay.
But doing pianos. But, you know, I'm talking to him about, and he's really interested in working with all the musicians and the people. You know, the poets, the musicians, the jazz, the comedy. He wants to maintain that, but he's going to completely renovate and take over. He's going to plan on opening it up in October 1st.
Okay.
Yeah, but it's kind of a dueling piano thing, and I'm kind of like, wow, you're going to pay these guys like $300 or more a piece to play when you could bring in people like you and give you guys
$300 each.
Wait, 300, why are we taking a pay cut with the new owner?
Yeah, man.
Wow, all right. Well,
I'm still gonna help him with the booking.
Oh, you are.
So if people are interested in playing, you can contact me at the same, and I'm gonna keep my numbers and contacts on Facebook alive, and I'll just be, you know, doing it for him, and I'll run it by him, you know, whatever he wants, in case nobody's bringing a piano.
As long as I can still jump out of a cake every now and then.
Okay.
Not
a trap
of
comedy night, Alan.
I'll be in a cake.
Anyway, so Nolan, thank you for putting this together tonight.
You've let me play here for, it's got to be over 20 years now, and I appreciate every minute of it. Thank you very much.
Yeah, it's been my pleasure to work with all of you guys, and also an important part is the support of people coming out to the shows and then the venues. That's, for me, it's just that equation of the venue, you guys, audience, it all makes it work.
It absolutely.
Thank you all.
Yeah.
Thank you.
A lot of local, well, artists, singers, songwriters, musicians, you know, they couldn't get booked anywhere else, but you book them here and they've gone on to do great things. And it's just,
sure.
I don't know that we have too many places like that left, so thank you so much. We love you and we appreciate that you've
been.
I saw
Jason Mraz on the stage.
Okay.
Like, artists booked fucking legends here before they were anything.
What about this one?
Okay.
Oh, my goodness. Okay. I love that.
Yes.
I don't want to play anymore. Do a sad song for us, don't
we? Okay.
This song about baseball.
Jordan's 10.
of vodka miles as we pack up the van again. Tomorrow is just gonna be another day. Here's the fastball. Here's to my own room. Here's to a night in my own bed. Here's to fastball. Here's to uncooked meals. Here's to the night.
It's a burden.
Yeah.
My athletic achievements. My pensions for what was my pension for again? My pension? Oh. That was way too truthful to be funny anymore. Alright, here's a song in which I shall require Kevin and Nolan to sing and harmonize beautifully like little birds. Yeah. Speaking of bird crap, I parked my car.
Wait a minute.
I said birds and Nolan yelled crap into a mic. I recently got a new car, which when you press the window thing, it goes up, which is awesome and really cool. Because I got mine fixed, but you still had to kind of pull for a while, like longer than you could still look cool doing. Like one hand would be cool and casual. Two hands, like unbuckle your seatbelt and yank while you're trying to hit the thing with your elbow. Not very cool. But anyway, so I parked the other one and thought, this will look great. But then birds like poop all over it. And I think the neighbors have noticed, wait, you haven't driven that because it would probably be washed. So there's my story about bird poop, bird crap. Let's forget it happened. But that's what I noticed today as I was rushing here. I was like, oh, wash the car and prepare a song intro. So one for two. This song will require you to sing and harmonize like birds.
This is the point where it all breaks down. Where you turn to me and say, today is never quite the saddest day.
Anything to do after this?
Yeah, I'm totally going out. I'm not sleeping. What?
I wrote the song because I was trying to write a replacement like ballad. Thank you.
That your name is Nola Nurk, which I think is cool.
I am not surprised. I get Colin, I get Olin, I get Noah,
Eric,
Nick.
It's starting to give me a complex because I come from a long line of mumblers, and like as we grow, the men in my family, we just go, like, you know how like I don't know if it's the same with women. I notice it more with men. Our noses and ears just continue growing like long past our death. So like, yeah, like you walk past a graveyard, you'll see like little nostrils like peering through the snow. But I come from a long line of mumblers, and I think it's exacerbated by the growing sound chambers that the males in my family have. And so when my voice to text tells me you're Nolan Erck, it just sends me down a rabbit hole of worry that like it's happened. I become my father. And for years has given like the family blessing, and it's like, do the Lord, thank you for the dream. And you can just hear the Lord going, what? Marvin, I don't, you can, you know what? Yeah, none of those are getting answered. I'm not sure, you can't bother to enunciate. No, you know what? No, go help someone else. No, Michael? No, he'll enunciate or go without blessings this fortnight or however they measure time. This, what amount of time? Now, that's against the rules up here. Okay, here's a song now that I'm totally not stalling before playing. Yeah, where'd I, thank you. Oh, see, that's why we have backups. That's why we have backups.
Oh,
do
you want this one too?
You know what? You know what, smarty pants? Yeah, I'm gonna do it. Yeah, give me that. Here's an old song before I became the master guitar that you see before you. This is, wait, no, hold on. This is before I knew that.
Stop being funny now, sir.
Okay, no, listen. This is before I knew that partial capos existed, and so this is what I did in my first band. It's a song, and I was like, you know, I could, wait. So that's what I did. It's the first song I wrote about a girl. Okay, the first, okay. That song, but just to show that those capos were there for a reason. This is the first song I wrote in the van that wasn't about a girl.
Something here, I forgot it. And every brand new day you got.
song. I'm going to do a song that... It's called Young Dumb Targets. It's a little short autobiography. Thank you guys for listening. Thank you for being here. Thank you, Nolan, for putting this all together.
Yeah.
Happy birthday. You again. We'll be here tomorrow to see our dear friends David Hughes from String Theory, Natalie Cortez.
Fantastic band and I will be playing at Chocotup on September 2nd, which is a Saturday, in the, I think it's scheduled to be 71 degrees, so pack a sweater, but at 1:45 we will be, braving heat exhaustion and singing some rockin' tunes, and we'll be joined by Hannah singing some vocals. And The name Alex Walker and the Impertinent. Alex Walker and the Unmitigated Gall. It'll be Alex Walker and then some multisyllabic, passive aggressive missive aimed at my band. But yeah,
that's about right.
So please come and yeah, and listen.
And I'll be what watching else? You from the merch tent.
Yes. Sorry, keep, yeah, you'll just see all these shirts that say Alex Walker and then just like things vigorously crossed out. How about you? Are you doing some solo things, Nolan?
No solo stuff coming up. I'm playing guitar with, so I have an 80s, 90s alternative cover band called Sergeant York that we occasionally bust out for acoustic covers of like your favorite REM and music songs and things of that nature. And we're playing the Don't You Forget About Me 80s tribute show.
Nice.
August 6th at whatever that place above Harlow's is called.
Starlight.
Yeah, that thing. It's 10 bands, and each of us is doing a different year from the 80s. We're doing 1985. It's right smack dab in the middle. And then I'm playing the aforementioned.
You're playing some bass with the band?
I'm playing some bass with Alex Walker's band at Chalk It Up.
Wait, you're in the Unmitigated Golf?
He's, yeah.
It had a different name when I
It was him. Mitigated before he showed up, and now mitigation to the wind.
There's a band name.
The amount of time spent at our band practice discussing what the rest of Alex Walker and the should be. If you could turn that into, you know, kilowatts, we could power a small city.
Your next band is going to be Alex Walker and the Lingering Resentment.
Alex Walker, the passive aggressive bass player.
Alex Walker,
the series of rebels.
All right.
Wow.
All
right. Quiet song or David Bowie sing along?
David Bowie.
Yeah.
Through the market square, so many mothers sighing. Tears had just come over. We had 5 years left to cry. News guy wept and told us Earth was really dying. Cried so much his face was wet, and I knew he was not lying. And I heard telephones, opera house, favorite melodies, boys, toys, electric guns and TVs. My brain ran like a warehouse and had no room to spare. Had to cram so many things to store everything in there. And all the fat skinny people and all the tall short people and all the nobody people and all the somebody.
Thanks, everybody.
The cool thing that I've learned late and trying to pass on to my children early is that you're not in control of everything, and it's not a sign of failure. It just is. You're not in control of everything, and what you can do is do your best in that moment, and that's enough. And so I'm trying not to live paralyzed by or regretful from hindsight, but trying to go, okay, that's the best decision we could make with the information we had, and then we move on. And so the little snippet of therapy that snuck its way into the song is going that some things aren't up to me, and that's okay, and it's not that I need to try harder and clasp and clench harder to make everything be up to me, but it's just kind of a thing of letting go and going, yeah. So that's what I've learned, and if I could articulate it better, then I'd probably be done with therapy, I guess. Maybe this is as strong as we'll be.
Thank you. Alex Walker. Thank you, ladies, for coming and hanging out. Have a good night.
Happy birthday.
Thank you, Mark. Thank you.